Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to create a simple query in Microsoft Access. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. First, I would like to define for you what a query is. A query is simply a question that you are asking of a set of data. It's also a way to view, add, change, or delete data inside of a database. So let's revisit the database that we've been working with since the beginning of our Access series. Here is the customers table in our customer purchases database. A table inside of Access includes all of the information that you might need. So in this case, we have name and street and city, state, zip, phone, email, etc. But what if we wanted to look at a subset of this data? In some cases, a table can have many, many, many records and many, many, many fields. Remember, a record is a row of information depicting information about individual customers. And a field is a column of the same information for all records. So in this case, name is a field, street is a field, city is a field, etc. But a query allows you to limit the number of records that are returned and or the number of fields you wish to return. So let's see how that's done based on the data set that we have right here. If I go up to create and I go to query design, let's review a couple standard things before we go about building our query. First of all, in a query, you have this window up here in this gray area. That window is called the object relationship pane. And down here, you have what's known as the design grid. And this area pulls out the information that you will want to see from your data source that goes up here in the object relationship pane. So in the object relationship pane, we need to start with an object. And remember, an object in Microsoft Access is either a table, a query, a form, a report, a module, or a macro. But when we're dealing with queries, we really only want to use table objects or query objects. So in this case, let's add the customers table. There are two different ways I can add a table to my query. First of all, I can left click and keep the mouse button down and drag a table into my query. And that table will be up here in the relationship pane. But if I click on that table and hit delete, I can also right click in the object relationship pane and go to show table. And then I can double click on a table from my list over here. And if you look up here, I can also choose a query as a data source for my new query. But for now, I'm just going to double click on customers. And you will notice that when creating queries, there is often more than one way to do the same action. So I will try to review a couple of those as we go on today. After I've added the table that I wanted up here, I can close this window by hitting the X. I can also hover over my table until I get this double-headed arrow, hold down my left mouse button, and drag downward. And then I will be able to see all the fields that are available in my table. So let's say in this case, I would like to first limit the number of columns I am returning in my query. So I'm going to double click on name and state. And then I would like to show you that I'm now not returning the entire table. I'm limiting only the number of columns that will be in my table. So there's three different ways I can view the query results. One way is up here under this view menu. I can hit this data sheet view. A second way, I can go down here to this icon, which also says data sheet view. And as a third way, I can right click on this tab up here and I will see data sheet view. All of those are going to take you to exactly the same place. But I like to go up here to the tabs because it's a shorter distance for my mouse and I feel like it's more efficient. So when I hit data sheet view, I can see that I'm now returned with just my limited columns of name and state. But look at this other tab over here. This is still my customers table. If I go back there, there's a lot more fields inside of my customer table. But I'm going to click back on my query. I've now limited this to two columns. I can also limit the number of records I would like to return. So if I right-click on this tab and go back to Design View, let's see how we can limit those records. So looking down here in the grid, you can see this is a field, and I'm returning the field name and the field state. My next option is called Table. In this case, we only have one table inside of our object or relationship pane, but in future videos, I'll show you how you can have more than one table, and this comes into play. But for now, if I click in here, you can see this down arrow, and it tells me what all my tables are inside of the object or relationship pane. My next option down here is to sort. So if I were to go over here under state and hit this down arrow, I could select ascending order. So let me just show you that really quickly right now. I'm going to right click and go to datasheet view, and you can now see all my states are in alphabetical order. But I want to limit the number of rows coming back. So I'm going to right click and go to design view. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. But now I'm going to go down here to the criteria. And if I click here, let's say I just want to return everything in Ohio. Because this is a text field, I need to enclose the value that I want to return in double quotes. However, let me delete that for you and just type OH again and click out of there, and you will see that Access will automatically put those double quotes in there. So now if I run this query, you can see I'm only getting one record returned and two columns returned, because I have told Access that I only want the name column, the state column, and any rows that include Ohio. And let's go back to design view. And if I look again at my customers table right here, what if I wanted to return Ohio and Oklahoma? I could go back to my query, and I could also put OK down here for Oklahoma. And I'm going to hit the down arrow, and you can see that Oklahoma was automatically put into double quotes as well. So if I run this query by right-clicking and going to datasheet view, you can see I'm now returned with Ohio or Oklahoma. But I'm going to show you something else that's really cool. If I right-click here and go back to design view, what if I wanted to return all states that start with an O? I'm going to delete both of these out of here, and I'm going to use a keyword called like. And I'm going to say like with a space, a double quote in O, and then I'm going to put a star right here and close my double quotes. The star is what's known as a wildcard character, so it will return anything starting with an O. So if I click out of there and right click on my query and go to datasheet view, you can see I'm still returned with every state that starts with an O. If I go to design view and I go back to my table, what if I wanted to return everything that started with an I? I could go back to my query and change out this O for an I, and then run my query. And you can see I am now only getting states that start with an I. So the wildcard is really, really useful, especially when people are misspelling information and you still want to see those query results. So I'm going to go back to design view, and let's look at my original data set one more time. What if I wanted to return anything that started with an I and anything that had a zip code of 22222? Let's go back to my query. First of all, I would have to add the zip code field. Now I want to be careful because I want to return any state that starts with an I and a zip code that is 22222. So do you see this OR right here? This allows me to have an OR type criteria. So I should be returning three records, both of the states that start with an I and the one that has the zip code of 22222. So I'm going to right click and go to datasheet view, and you can now see This one's returned because the state starts with an I, same as this. But this one's returned because of the zip code. So the criteria on here is either the state starts with an I or the zip code is 22222. If I go back to my customers table, and let's say I copy this Texas record right here, but I want to make this one in Waco, Texas, and I want to call this customer 10. I also need to change my ID over here to 10 because this is a unique field. So if I go back to my query and I say, I want the state to be Texas. Let's say I no longer want the zip code. I'm going to highlight this column until I get this thick arrow. And then I will click and select the entire column and hit delete on my keyboard. And then I'm going to double click and add city instead. So this time, instead of using an or, I'm going to click in here and put a double quote and type Waco. So this query reads like this. I want to see my customer names where the state is equal to Texas and the city is equal to Waco. So if I right click here and go to datasheet view, you can see I'm only getting one record because looking back at the original data set in the customers table, there is only one record that has Waco and Texas. But if I were to go back to my query and change this to an or, instead of being on the same line, it's on a different line. Then when I run this query, you can see that I'm returned with anything where the state is Texas or the city is Waco. So that's why I will be returned with two records. It takes a little bit to get the and the or straight in your head, but as soon as you understand them, it becomes a very useful tool. So finally, if I go back to design view of my query, if I know that this is a query I would like to use in the future, I can just go over here to the save icon and hit save. And I will be prompted to give this query a name. I like to start all my queries with QRY, and I will call this one Waco or Texas and say okay. And then anytime in the future, I can come back and I can use this query again because this is saved as an object over here underneath my queries. And all of my objects are saved in my database file. And you can see the name of that database file right up here. Access Introduction to Database.ACCDB. One final thing I do want to say is in this kind of query, which is known as a select query, if I go here and go to the datasheet view, say I were to change the state right here for Texas to Tennessee. If I go back to my customers table, you will see that my Waco record is now in Tennessee, even though I have updated that right here in my query. I just want to be sure that you know that when you update data inside of a select query, that update is actually taking place in the underlying table. So if I go back to design view, any data I change will be being changed right here in my customers table. I just want to make you aware that those changes made in a query are in fact changing the table and that data is actually being updated through the query. So hopefully that gives you a quick overview of a very, very simple Microsoft Access query. We will go over many, many more queries in our Access series coming later this year. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks again for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.